Track number 8 on disc 1 score presentation of a Godfather 50th anniversary, expanded and remastered edition. Bad luck, / Sicilian message, / meditation. Again, better set tracks, with combining 3 cues in one. The first taking its name from when Sollozzo tells Tom they hit him with 5 shots and he's still alive. Well, that's bad luck for me and bad luck for you if you don't make that deal. After being told that Don Corleone has survived the assassination attempt. The second, as Clemenza tells Sonny, it's a Sicilian message. It means Luca Brasi sleeps with the fishes. As Tessio brings him a package that was left at the gate, a dead fish wrapped into Luca's bulletproof vest. The third is a statement that was used to create another cue, but wasn't placed in the movie as a standalone, if I understand correctly. Meditation plays as a part of the Hearts of Fear, which underscores Michael arriving at the hospital to visit his father. Across these cues, a piano, bassoon, horn, oboe, clarinet, viola, cello, guitar, trumpet, and string section are playing. As we look at how to play this on the mandolin, we shall start with the tuning. Standard G, D, A, E. Piano opens the track. So what is happening here is that the piano is playing slash chords, consisting of a note in the low octave combined with it in a higher one. Our first chord is going to be an A slash A, which we can transpose to the mandolin by strumming together the second fret on the G with a muted D and A string, so those do not ring out, and the fifth fret on the E. This will always be a doublet, so we'll strum it twice. And I'm not even using my other fingers to mute those strings here, but just the way my index finger naturally curls around them. The next chord is going to be an A sharp / A sharp. And this is where we'll notice that there's an octave jump. Rather than now moving this up one fret, we'll instead be strumming together the third fret on the G, the muted D, and the first fret on the A. What I mean to say is that between this A and this one, there's also another. So our doublets from here on out are going to consist of this A slash chord in the first and third octave. The accentuating chords between that are going to consist of the first and second octaves. So back to the doublet. Then our next chord is going to be a B slash B, strumming together the 4th fret on the G, the muted D, and the 2nd fret on the A. Then the doublet again. Then the next chord is going to be a C slash C, strumming together the 5th fret on the G, the muted D, and the 3rd fret on the A. And the doublet once again. We'll be letting this ring out as we move into the next segment. And now that we've learned the spar, let's play through it at a slower pace. Simultaneously, there's a horn heard in the background of this. This being another A note, which we can play way up here on the 17th fret of the E. That rings out throughout the entirety of the bar. Easier said than done on the mandolin, but we'll keep that in mind for an idea for later. And simultaneously, a bassoon is playing there. What I'm doing here is playing a fretted harmonic. Because this too is playing an A note, however, even lower than what the piano is playing as its bass note. Since we're running out of space, out of range on the mandolin, this is one way to transpose it, but it's entirely optional, really. Rather than striking the string by placing a finger across the fret and producing the overtone like this, we'll be fretting the second fret on the G, and then place the index finger of the picking hand 12 frets higher, which will be the 14th. Now I'm using the thumb to hit the string, producing the overtone like this. The next segment has the oboe taking the lead. Playing the melody to the new Godfather. Starting on the 5th fret E. After a moment the 8th, 7th, and 4th. That will let ring out before continuing on the open string. Then the 3rd fret. After a moment the 5th, 3rd, and the open string. The first bar, the second one, begins on the 10th fret. After a moment, the 13th, 12th, 9th, that we let ring out, before playing the 12th fret A, 8th fret E, after a moment, the 10th, 8th, and 11th fret A. At the same time, the clarinet is going to be playing with this in the lower octave. Same timing, same notes, just at a lower pitch. Now starting from the open A. After a moment the 3rd fret, 2nd, and 6 fret D. Very let ring out. Then the second, fifth, after a moment we open A, fifth fret D, and second. Letting it ring out for the first bar. Second bar, starting on the fifth fret A, after a moment the first fret E, the open string, and the fourth fret A, letting it ring out, then the open string, the third fret, and after a moment the fifth, third, and the sixth fret D. Simultaneously, the string section is going to be playing in the background. Always coming in as the lead melody of that oboe and clarinet are holding their notes. So right after the first note is being played, the strings come in on the 5th fret A. Repeat this twice. And then the 4th. It's the first bar. And the second one will be on the 10th. Repeat this twice. And simultaneously, the viola is going to be playing accents here. With this not mirroring what the higher strings are playing, we'll be omitting the first note and coming on the second, which will be the second fret G. Letting it ring out, then playing it again. Letting it ring out, then the fifth, and now the viola plays an additional note on the fourth at the end of the bar. Once more, omitting the first note in the second bar, coming in for the second, which will be the open D, letting it ring out, and playing it once more. At 52 seconds, Bad Luck fades out. After a very brief pause, the next cue, Sicilian Message, begins to play. The cello here being prominent. With this almost hinting at the Godfather chords. We'll be on the 4th fret G, followed by the 5th, repeat, repeat, then the 6th, and the 5th, letting it ring out. Simultaneously, the cello is going to play under this. Which begins by mirroring what the cello is doing just as threaded harmonics in our transposer. So on the 4th fret G again, the 5th, repeat. Repeat, now the 6th, the 5th, but will that ring out? And then we'll be adding in the 6th, that will slide down to the 5th, without plucking it again. At the end of the bar, the trumpet will play accents, which will be a double on the 4th fret E, that will then stop from ringing out. Another accent will be the guitar. This being a singular pluck of the 5th fret of the D. Which is also where the string section is going to join. On the 4th fret A, with a continuous tremolo. If you're not familiar, all it is rapid alternating down and up picking. Holding this note and then fading out. Which at 1:02 fades out. A moment later, the next cue, Medtitation, comes in. This being played by the oboe, again picking up the melody to the new Godfather. This time from the 3rd fret A, after a moment for 6th, 5th, 2nd, letting it ring out, then continuing on the 5th fret D, the 1st fret A, the 3rd, the 1st, and the 5th fret D, letting it ring out for the track to fade out. the same time, the clarinet is playing with this. In the octave up, again same notes, same timing. The reason I played it so quietly is because those will all be ghost notes, is playing at a significantly lower volume than the oboe is. Now on the 8th fret E that we simply pluck gently, after a moment the 11th, 10th, 7th, letting it ring out before continuing on the 10th fret A, the 6th fret E, 8th, 6th, and the 10th fret A. Simultaneously, the string section playing in the background. Coming in right with the first note on the 8th fret E. Letting it ring out and playing it once more. Then the 4th. With a viola, here once more accentuating. This time it does come in with the first note of the bar already, which will be the first fret on the D, letting it ring out and plucking it again. Once more, and then a final time, with the next note being only played by the viola, which will be the open string. One additional thought here at the end. As mentioned, the mandolin is going to have trouble sustaining a note throughout an entire bar by just being plucked once. Considering how we went over tremolo for a part of the string section here, it's worth a consideration whether we would like to use that to sustain the notes rather than plucking individual notes as done for most of the session. If we take what the horn is playing in the intro bar, could be sustaining this throughout the entirety of it by playing tremolo continuously. But that is up to the player.